الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام: والذي نفسي بيده لا تقوم الساعة حتى تكلم السباع الإنس، وحتى تكلم الرجل عذبة صوته وشراك نعله، وتخبره فخذه بما أحدث أهله من بعده. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, by the one in whose hand is my soul, the hour will not be established until predators speak to people, and until the tip of a man's web and the straps on his sandal speak to him, and his thigh informs him of what occurred with his family after him. This is one of the signs, brothers and sisters, one of the signs of the hereafter. And one of them happened according to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The wolf spoke, and also this will happen. These animals will tell you something. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حَتَّى تُكَلِّمَ السِّبَاعِ. The lion, the tiger, the wolf, they will speak to the human beings. How? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who gave us the power and the ability to speak, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make these animals to speak. Not only that, even the stick or the web, the tip of the web of the man will speak to him. وَشِرَاكُ نَعْلِهِ. Your slipper, your shoes, subhanallah, the thread in your shoes will speak to you. And also, at the end of the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, وَتُخْبِرُهُ فَخِذُهُ. Your thigh, subhanallah, will tell you what your family, what your wife had done after you. You are not at home, you traveled, you are in the masjid, you are absent, not at home. Your thighs will tell you what your wife did after you. These are some of the signs of the hereafter. These signs will happen and people will experience that. And as I mentioned, one of them happened during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when a shepherd came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and told him that he was in the with his herd, and a wolf came and took one of the sheep. Then the shepherd saved this sheep from that wolf. Then the wolf spoke to that shepherd, subhanallah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I believe in that, and also Abu Bakr and Umar believe in that. And of course, all of us as Muslims, we should believe in these authentic ahadith. Also, one of the signs, brothers and sisters, one of the signs will happen before the Day of Judgment. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the Mahdi will be of my stock and will have a broad forehead, a prominent nose. He will fill the earth with equity and justice, with equity and justice, as it was filled with oppression and tyranny, and he will rule of 7 years. Another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if only one day of this world remained, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would lengthen that day till he raised up in it a man who belongs to me or to my family, his name like my name, and whose father's name is the same as my father's name, which means his name Muhammad ibn Abdullah, who will fill the earth with equity and justice as it has been filled with oppression and tyranny. This is also one of the signs of the hereafter. And this is the near, and the scholars mention this is with the time of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. As the scholars mentioned, some of the minor signs will be among and with the major signs, because Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, I mean the coming back of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, this is one of the signs, one of the major signs of the year after, and he will kill al-Masih al-Dajjal, the false Messiah, bi babi Lud, bi Philistine, in a place called Lud, where in Palestine. When the Masih al-Dajjal, when the false Messiah sees Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam said he will dissolve like the salt when dissolved in water. Subhanallah. He will attack everyone, Masih al-Dajjal. But when he sees Isa, because he knows that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is the only one who can kill him, and he will kill him, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. This man, Muhammad ibn Abdullah, he is different than Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned with a broad forehead, ajla al-jabha, aqna al-anf, prominent nose. His name like my name. His father's name like my father's name. Muhammad ibn Abdullah. Yamla al-ard. He will fill this earth with justice. And it was full of oppression and dhulm. بعد أن تكون الدنيا ظلما وجورا سبحان الله. الحمد لله, we do not reach to this time, but a time will come, it will be full of injustice and سبحان الله oppression everywhere. So this man, another hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said يصلح الله في ليلة, which scholars say it means he was not a good man, but he will be a good man within one night. This happens, brothers and sisters. Sometimes you'll find the brother or a sister, subhanallah, very bad. They don't care about the salah, don't care about the hijab, music, wine, all the sins, but because of one word or because of a car accident. So within 1 minute or 1 hour, subhanallah, they change and they shift 180 degrees from a very bad person to a very good person. So Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Yuslihu Allahu fi layla," and he will lead the salah and Isa alayhi salatu wasalam behind him. When they tell Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, come and lead the salah, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will refuse. Why? As an honor for this ummah, that the leader from this ummah, not me. And this is like a sign that we will follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam even at the time when Isa comes down alayhi salatu wasalam. And this man, subhanallah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned he will stay 7 years with justice. العدل يملأ الدنيا عدلا وقسطا. And this is, subhanallah, needed for people to live in justice. And قسط, also قسط means justice, عدل. Because the justice, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the heavens and earth with justice. أقام السماوات والأرض بالعدل. So this man will come, and the scholars mention from narrations he will be from the children of Al-Hasan ibn Ali رضي الله تعالى عنهما. قل ما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده, أما بعد, يقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام لا يكونن من أمتي أقوام يستحلون الحرى والحرير والخمر والمعازف. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, from among my followers there will be some people who will consider zina, adultery, the wearing of silk, الحرير, the drinking of خمر, and the use of musical instruments as lawful. Subhanallah, this is a very clear hadith, and we see this hadith, subhanallah, nowadays. Many aspects from this hadith are there. لَيَكُونَنَّ مِنْ أُمَّتِي, not all of my nation, some of my nation, some of my followers, people. يَسْتَحِلُّونَ, what is the meaning of يَسْتَحِلُّونَ? It is clearly haram, forbidden, not allowed. But what they will consider this as halal. What is the meaning of that? Some scholars say they will practice these forbidden things, these illegal things, as they are lawful. And we mentioned the zina, al-hir, والحرير. The second point, الحرير. We spoke about the adultery in a previous khutbah. And the second point, silk, which means for men. It is for women, halal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam came out to the companions with silk and gold. And he said, هذاني حرام على ذكور أمتي حل لإناثها. These two things are halal, lawful for women, but haram for men, for the males. And nowadays you notice some people don't care. This is haram, this is halal, they practice. If they like, they will buy. The men should be different than women. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, وَلَيْسَ الدَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْتَى. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين وقوموا إلى الصلاة.